about Even the Rain. Tell us about the story.
Well, it's quite a complicated story, really. It comes from my long friendship with a wonderful historian called Howard Zinn, a wonderful radical historian who wrote probably one of the best books about the history of the United States, called The People's History of the United States. Unfortunately, he died at the beginning of this year. But he starts his wonderful book by the arrival of Columbus, and he takes this iconic figure and he stands on his head and he examines what Columbus did when he first went there in 1492. The search for gold, the slavery, the torture, the murder, the extermination of the Indian population. And really, we tell the story through the eyes of a cynical producer and a more idealistic director who go to Bolivia to try and make a story about this. They've got a very tight budget, and they go to Bolivia because they think they can actually tell a big film with lots of extras. And in the course of this, trying to make the historical film, they are ambushed really by the water wars that really took place in 2000 in Bolivia, which went to do with the privatization of water. So they kind of end up getting mixed up in an historical perspective and at the same time in a contemporary war, the water wars of Cochabamba in Bolivia. So it's a very kind of complex structure. But we have two wonderful actors, Gabriel Garcia Bernal, who many people will know from The Motorcycle Diaries or And Your Mother Too, and one of the best Spanish directors, actors, a guy called Luis Tosar, who plays a very cynical producer. So it was quite a complex one to pull off. It was a very, very difficult shoot in Bolivia, in the jungle, in the rainy season, and then we had to work with the indigenous population. So it was very complex to pull together, but it was a great experience there.